Hey everybody, Fred Bernardo, the Smoking Guitar Player here. Today, we're going to replace a gasket. Cleaning this goo off a medium egg here, and this is the best way I've found so far. This is acetone soaked Scotch-Brite pad. Glove, go like this, then break it up with this here razor blade, a sharp one, and start getting it. You can see it start loosening. Let the acetone soak in and then kind of break it up with the blade. Get it out of those little grooves. And more scrubbing with the acetone. And then more coming back. And you do this until it's either white, like here, or you just can't stand it anymore, and then you put your gasket on. We'll show you that next. You may notice here we have the top dome of the egg flipped upside down in the base just to make a nice work surface. Try not to gouge the camera person or even your own private parts with this blade while you're doing this. If necessary, get one of those steel bead G-strings. Get some good acetone. Oh yeah, baby. There it goes. You see, that is goo. It looks like it's a black stain, but it turns out it's goo. Really digging into it with this blade. And then you change your blade. Look at this, I'm getting even more of this. The more you dig, the more you get. Put some acetone on there, scrub it a little, and then dig around with this thing. Now at one point I switched to a new blade and flipped it over here and went to the other side, and it really worked good, but I'm too lazy to go back in the house and get another one. So, because I'm almost finished, I'm just about out of steam. And when I run out of gas, that's when I'll put the new gasket on and we'll film that. Okay, folks, so we've got a ceramic grill here. This happens to be a big green egg medium, and the gasket was completely shot. So today we're going to not only replace a gasket, we're going to do a little experiment in the world of ceramic grills. And what I have here, I have a gasket that is double the thickness of the normal gasket. And we're just going to replace the top. We're not going to replace the bottom. This egg always had a sealing problem. The gasket always falls off because it doesn't seal right, so it burns itself off. So I'm going to experiment today with just doing the top and then see if I can get the top to the dome to seat to the base properly. But I have it twice as thick because the hinge is calibrated for a quarter of an inch. The normal gasket is an eighth. This gasket is one of our special gaskets that's a quarter of an inch. So, we took our acetone and all our scrapers as we showed you, and we scraped all the goo and all the grease and everything off of the surface. We really got it nice and dry. I'm not even going to touch it and get my finger oils on there. And I'm now going to put the gasket on. Now, if you look inside here, here's the thermometer on the dome indicating the front of the egg. So I'm going to start up here on the side about halfway to the front. That seems to be a good spot. I'm going to make sure that I stay back from the edge of the egg and not let the gasket get into the egg so it can catch on fire. We don't want to do that. So I peel it off and I put it on. Now it's very important that you don't stretch this gasket. You want to bend it around the egg. And I use my finger to keep it maybe a 1/16 of an inch underneath the overhang. And I'm bending the gasket, almost forcing, like in the sewing business, what they would call a little dart. Yeah. Okay, so we're putting it on here. We're keeping the edge back about a 1/16 of an inch. And we're actually forming little gathers almost. We do not want to stretch this. The very first one I ever put on, I stretched and made real nice. The first time I lit the egg and it heated up, the glue let go. And, you know, this glue is really sort of an issue. I've been experimenting lately with glues and things and with different gasket materials, so we'll keep you posted. But for now, we're staying about an 1/8 to 1/16 of an inch back. I got a little carried away there. And I'm peeling away with my right hand. I'm peeling away at the last second. I'm peeling away this backing strip and pushing down. So being a guitar player, my left hand fingers are extra agile. That makes it nice. Comes in handy for these kind of little operations. And I'm kind of pulling back on it here. I'm making sure I got it, that I'm not stretching it, because that stretching is bad, trust me. It lets go immediately, so I'm negative stretching it. I'm actually compressing it a little bit. And we're about halfway around. We're going to keep going. Now, if the camera person wants to pan the camera around the deck here a little bit, we have two guests observing us today. This is father-in-law and mother-in-law of the Smokin' Guitar Player. Father-in-law and mother-in-law of Smokin' Guitar Player. Right there they are, folks. So they're our observers today. And that's right. And when I'm done, they're probably applaud. So if you hear applause, that's going to be them because, you know, they're watching this gasket being put on here very intently. They're very curious as to what the hell I'm even doing. They don't even have a clue here if they're wondering why anybody would do something so crazy. But it was nice. I had father-in-law Nick as an assistant, and he's an expert with sealing. He's an expert with sealing surfaces. Being a premier saxophone repairman, nobody knows anything more about sealing surfaces than he does. I'm going to trim just a little off of here because it got a little more air than I wanted it to. I don't even want air getting to this thing. I don't know why, but that's the way I feel about it. I'm going to let this overlap a little bit. I'm going to pull that over there. And I'm going to try with my really sharp scissors that I have here to cut this in such a way that there's maybe just a little bit extra to push in there. Now I'm going to get rid of this gasket. And with my hand, carefully, I'm going to try and push it down. All right. Now I'm going to flip the dome over. I'm going to try and get it back without wrecking anything inside the spring band, and maybe we'll do that right now. There we can go. I'm loosening this way up. If you look, if we can get a close-up over here, I'm loosening this very loose and pushing them apart. That way I have plenty of room to get the dome in, because otherwise the dome might get ornery, because that gasket hangs out on the outside edge. You can see it hanging out here, so I need a lot of extra room. Okay, now, we have it on there, and if you get in here close, down here, you can see the gasket sticking out because it's sticking out on the outside, which is okay. I'm going to pull the spring band up here as far as possible, and then I'm going to start tightening it. But I'm going to pull it up all the way around the egg, and this works with any ceramic grill pretty much the same way, and then I'm going to start cranking on these nuts and bolts. Now, we'll be curious to see. This egg had a huge gap in the back no matter what I did. It'll be curious to see. Hey, father-in-law, you got a bill, a dollar bill on you. We'll do the dollar bill test. Any bill. You'll be getting it back. Possibly. Unless I decide to keep it. We're going to crank on this. Thanks. Okay, I'll give it back to you then, like, next Thursday, if that's okay with you.
That's why I said, do you have a 20?
Right, should have taken a 20. But, you know. Okay, so. I'm going to put it in there. Now, as I said, this egg was at a big gap back there. And as you see, it is still too loose. So the experiment is kind of a failure. It's a semi-failure. But what I'll do is, I'll put a normal width gasket on the bottom. Which means I've got to start scraping with acetone again. I really don't feel like doing it. But anyway, you've gotten to see here how to put your gasket on. And remember, you tighten this bolt right here till it bends, till the bolt bends. And then you come back in a couple weeks or in a week and you tighten it some more, because you do not want the hot dome dropping out. Okay, folks, see you later. That's how you put on a new gasket. Take care.